Good morning, dear colleagues.
Let me first to thank the organizers for the opportunity to have this very important discussion on a topic of common interest, such as the perspectives of the Black Sea security. The Black Sea security region is a crossroad and intersection of ways between Europe and Middle East, from the Eastern Balkans to the South Balkans. Like many such points of intersection, it is often a friction point. This is very much the case in the current geopolitical environment of growing confrontation between Russia and the West. The Black Sea region still plays an important strategic role, as the geopolitical realities highlight that establishing control over principal trade routes crossing the Black Sea has always been the interest of regional or even global powers. In this logic, access to the Black Sea is vital for all littoral or neighboring states and greatly enhances the possibility of projecting the power into further regions. The threats and vulnerabilities to the security of the Black Sea are diverse and multiple. Main security threats of the region are represented by the geographical factors, such as proximity to frozen conflicts, porous borders, ethnic or nationalistic tensions, transnational criminal organizations, and terrorist or extremist groups. All of this representing serious threats to the riparian states, as well as to the fundamental rights of the citizens. Following Russia's annexation of Crimea, the Black Sea region has been subject to a constant and accelerated militarization. The increase in the quantity and complexity of the military capabilities concentrated in the region represents a matter of real concern for the regional and global actors. The annexation of Crimea and the emergence of two separatist republics in eastern Ukraine have radically transformed the strategic landscape in the wider Black Sea region, as Russia and the West have entered a period of military political confrontation. Russia and NATO cannot rally on each other's good intentions. Russia perceives its military buildup in Crimea as defensive, but NATO and EU partners consider it as offensive and answers with symmetrical measures. The Russian Federation is seeking the consolidation of its power in its near abroad, and states like Ukraine, Georgia, and the Republic of Moldova have become the object of continuous containment. EU's and NATO's approach for the region through the enlargement policy, the Partnership for Peace program, or even the membership action plans have intensified Russia's so-called perception of insecurity. It has also contributed to the consolidation of the narratives that picture the Russian Federation as a victim of the Western aggression, which has no other alternative than the increase of its military capabilities. Additional countries in the Black Sea region have been subject to coordinated non-military actions, intensive disinformation campaigns, interference in the electoral processes, economic pressures, cyber operations, cultural and ethnic leverages meant to shape their orientation in the East-West confrontation. The Black Sea is also a strategic route for the export of a substantial part of Russia's energy. Oil and oil products are shipped on huge tanker vessels that circulate between Novorossiysk in the Black Sea coast and the Mediterranean Sea crossing the Turkish Straits. The existing Trans-Black Sea gas pipeline, called the Blue Stream, connects Russia and Turkey directly through the Black Sea. Following the tactical rapprochement between Moscow and Ankara in summer 2017, the construction of the Turk Stream gas pipeline has begun, a new export gas pipeline from Russia to the European part of Turkey. On the other hand, the area status as a point of intersection and an important transit corridor emphasize the vulnerabilities and risks generated by the migratory flows fleeing the regions affected by conflicts. The Black Sea route is not a favored options for refugees and migrants and illegal border crossings are still at low level comparing to other migratory routes, but on a growing trend. Another crucial source of risk to the security environment in the Black Sea region is the existence of long frozen conflicts. Protracted conflicts affecting Georgia, Moldova, Armenia, Azerbaijan, and the ongoing military conflict in eastern Ukraine remain a challenge to democratic development and security of the region. These conflicts continue to prevent development and create hardships in our countries. Russia maintains and intensifies military bases in Armenia, the occupied territories and separatist regions of Georgia and Moldova, respectively, as part of its strategy of playing a predominant regional role in Eastern Europe, as well as of using military presence as a leverage to exert pressure on these countries in contradiction with its international commitments to uphold the international legal order. In contrast, the EU, in line with the principles of sovereignty, territorial integrity, peaceful settlement of disputes, and inviolability of borders, has supported the territorial integrity of affected countries and refused to recognize breakaway regions as independent states. It has engaged in political dialogue and mediation on all the conflicts with the aim of reaching peaceful solutions. It supports the full and genuine implementation of the Minsk agreements in eastern Ukraine, of the 1999 Istanbul OSCE decision as regards the withdrawal of Russian troops from the territory of the Republic of Moldova, the OSCE Minsk group and its co-chairs in their efforts to solve the Nagorno-Karabakh conflict and avoid any new eruption of violence and military fighting. The EU co-chairs the Geneva International discussions on the consequences of Russia-Georgia conflict and constantly calls for full implementation by Russia of the 2008 ceasefire agreement and is an active observer in the 5+2 format for the settlement process of the Transnistrian conflict. The Republic of Moldova stays engaged and will continue to advocate consistently for the unconditional withdrawal of Russian troops and ammunition from the Moldovan territory, as well as for the transformation of the current peacekeeping operation on the Dniester River into a multinational civilian mission with an international mandate. The issue concerning the illegal presence of foreign troops has been addressed recurrently since 1992. Despite the fact the Russian Federation has repeatedly committed itself to withdrawing its troops from the region and to respecting the sovereignty and territorial integrity of the Republic of Moldova, it has constantly defied the common sense. The actual illegal military presence counts about 1,700 soldiers and about 20,000 tons of ammunition stored in Kolbasna, a small village close to the Ukrainian border. Despite the fact that all parties support mediation efforts and peaceful settlement of the conflicts in the Black Sea region, so far diplomatic and mediation efforts have turned out to be insufficient to set positive prospects for the conflict. The EU and NATO should increase their efforts in order to reach a peaceful resolution of all ongoing conflicts neighborhood that threaten European security as a whole and commit to sustaining the unity of action among EU and NATO member states in maintaining collective pressure on Russia. All common security challenges usually are connected and we must face them together. Join our forces in countering political populism, resurrection of economic protectionism, and last but not the least, return of brutal geopolitics into inter-state relations. Our objectives are to keep our countries stable by increasing resilience, reducing internal divisions, and resolving the protracted conflicts. In conclusion, the real challenge is how to enhance cooperation between our countries with the support of our Western partners in order to improve the security realities and tackle common threats. Thank you for your attention.